Welcome to the channel, guys. This video is the sequel to the three-part series of how to use a NOR gate as a universal gate. In the earlier videos, we saw how to use NOR as NOT gate and OR gate. And later in the second video, the use of NOR as AND as well as NAND gate was seen. Links to those videos are in the description box below. In today's video, we will see how to use NOR to create XOR and XNOR gates. Once again, we will be taking the aid of this table for the conversions. To represent XOR gate shown in purple with its symbol, expression and truth table by using the NOR gate which is shown in blue, it means you have to write the equation for XOR, that is Y equals A bar B plus AB bar in the format of NOR, that is Y equals A plus B the whole bar. To begin with the derivation, write Y equals A bar B plus AB bar. Please note that this is the same as Y equals A bar dot B plus A dot B bar. Whether or not you write the dot operator, it means the same. To simplify the expression such that it fits in the NOR form, we add AA bar plus BB bar to the existing expression. This does not alter the existing expression because if you refer back to the table, AA bar equals 0. Now you have 4 terms and you can spot some common terms, so start grouping them. So from first and third term you have A bar as common. And from second and fourth term, you have B bar as common. You might say, why not take A and B as commons? Taking A and B as common is the procedure when you are using NAND gate to express XOR. I got a trick here to remember which commons to take when. So if you are using NAND gate to make XOR or XNOR, you take A common because NAND has the letter A in it. And if you are using NOR to make XOR or XNOR, then you take A bar common because NOR does not have A in it. Now check this equation for NOR. It is still not in the desired format, but you got a term A shown in red and a term B which is shown in green. The top bar is missing for now. If I decide to put it at this stage itself, then in the next step it will get converted into a dot and the whole equation will not remain in the same format. So we don't do it at this stage itself. Instead, you see the first term and the second term have a dot which needs to be removed. So we put a double bar over them because the double bar will retain the original equation. Complement of a complement returns the original expression. Now when you do this, in the next step, you will get A bar and the dot will get converted into a plus followed by A plus B. The complement bar splits into two over each terms and the whole complement remains unaltered. The same steps repeat for the second terms. The dot converts to a plus, the first complement bar splits and the second one is unaltered. The terms can be simplified since complement of a complement returns the original expression. A double bar gives A and B double bar gives B. Now compare the expressions. The terms are in the required format. You got two NOR gates in the red colored box and two NOR gates in the green colored box. Only thing missing is the complement bar. As the rest of the terms are in order, you can now put a double bar. Check this against the desired NOR expression. The shaded area in yellow is the required representation, and the extra complement means that a NOT gate is required at the final output. For plotting, observe that A plus B the whole bar is common for both terms. So take a NOR gate and give the inputs as A and B. The output is going to be A plus B the whole bar. Next, to draw the part of the equation which is shown in green, you need the input A, and the second input will be the output from the first gate. So draw another NOR gate and connect the inputs. The output will be as shown. The same sequence will apply for the second term which is shown in blue. You need input B along with the second input as A plus B the whole bar. Draw the same and your output is going to be complement of B plus A plus B the whole complement. For drawing the part of the equation shaded in yellow, you will need the previous outputs as inputs to another NOR gate. So take complement of A plus B the whole bar as input 1 and complement of B plus A plus B the whole bar as input 2. The output will be the shaded equation in yellow. And to draw the last part which is shown in red, you need a NOT gate which can be created by shorting the inputs as shown in the previous video. We have covered all the parts which are to be drawn. And the end result is a combination of 5 NOR gates to give you an XOR gate. Once you get the XOR gate, going to XNOR is very easy. You negate the expression for XOR. When you take a complement of this previously derived equation, the bars cancel out, so you have a reduced equation which will need just 4 gates. Hence, the last NOT gate used will be omitted and the result is an XNOR gate as shown with 4 NOR gates. You may plot the truth tables and check against them. Thanks for watching and stay tuned for my next videos in which I'll use the NAND gate as universal gate to create the other gates in the logic gate family. As always, like, share and subscribe to never miss an update from Explanator, where every solution has a simple explanation.